Hello everyone, welcome back to this session wherein we'll look into a lab program, which is lab program number 6. So the objective here is we need to write a program which will draw a teapot, a simple shaded scene, so wherein we need to draw a teapot and a table like an image. So it should look like a table. On that table a teapot should be placed. So for this we need to choose the different properties of the light source, and these are phases on the, that is the objects, like the teapot, table. So for all these solid objects we need to choose different properties for the surface. So our expected output should look something like this. So if you observe here the output, so this is a teapot, which is being placed on a table, and also you can observe the wall here in the image. So let us see how we are basically drawing these. So we'll just you know, start from these different functions here and see what each of them are doing. We'll just brief each of them. So there's a function here called as teapot. So what is this teapot doing? Is this function will basically draw that teapot image, that is just the teapot. So first is we are using GL push matrix. So that is see, like in the previous programs we have already seen, that is how we set the matrix mode. So whatever is the current state, we need to save that current state and replace it in the stack. So we are using GL push matrix to save the current state. And then here, since there are many different objects which are being involved, we are individually drawing these different objects and translating it to that particular position on your screen. So for that reason we are using the translate f function, which is specifying your x, y and the z coordinate. So we already know that translation is a form of transformation. And then to draw the teapot, we are using glut solid teapot. So this is within the glut library you have a function which will draw you, or you know, which gives you that image of a teapot. So you can use that directly here. And once you are done with this, you are restoring the previous state. Before you started this, what was the previous state you need to restore? So you are using GL pop matrix. So now we are done with the defining function for teapot. Now we'll see how we can draw the tabletop. So in tabletop, again starting, we have used push matrix, we have used the translate xyz, and here we are using the scale function. So we know that scaling is a type of transformation. So why are we using this function? Is see, here in the output, if we see, for teapot we have used a direct function which is available under glut. But here if you are looking at this table top and these four legs, for all these we'll use the same type of function, that is we are using the solid cube function. So if you observe here, we are using glut solid cube function. So even to draw the table top, even to draw the table leg for all these, and also to draw the wall also, we are using the solid cube only. But how it looks? So for a wall, the way it looks is different. So wall you will be placing, or it is elongated in a vertical way, the table is in a horizontal way, and your walls are the height will be more So in this way, you are basically changing the way these objects look. You are using a solid cube only. So here, take this example. So you are using solid cube, wherein this 1.0 specifies the length of the sides here and how it should look, whether you know, you are scaling it along x-axis, scaling it with respect to y. Based on these scaling factors, we will make it to look like a tabletop, and here in this table leg, we'll make it to look like a leg. And in the same way, the same glut solid cube we are using to draw a wall also. So, and again, where exactly they should be placed, you are deciding it by using the translate function. So just using the solid cube, which is already a function which is available under the glut library, we are rendering a wall, we are rendering a table leg, a table top. And for a T, that is for a teapot, you're using the direct function. And then once you have drawn these objects, next is the light property. So here you're setting your ambient color. So all the light properties you are setting, that is the ambient, diffuse and the specular values, and then the shininess value also you're setting. And then the material, that is GL material FV. So basically here GL material is, it is this function under the GL library. This is used to specify the material properties. In any such lighting model, we use the GL material FV, where FV is nothing but the floating point vector. So if you look at the first parameter, so it specifies, that is, which material you are going to manipulate, or you're going to modify, whether you only the front or front and back. So in this way, which you're going to specify using GL underscore front, a constant you're specifying it. And then what is it parameter, whether the ambient, diffuse, specular lighting, which parameter, that is the second parameter. And then the third is the value. So first is which material you are modifying, and then next the parameter which has to be modified, and that parameter value you will be specifying as the third value within GL material FV. So in this way we are specifying our material properties here. And then after that you're specifying your light position as well as the intensity of your light. And here GL light FV, it also sets the value of any light source, that is the individual light source parameters. And here we have again the same way three parameters, that is the value parameter, and then what is that material value you are going to change, you will specify it. And here the maximum is specified as a constant, GL max light minus 1 or something. So till that value you can basically specify here. And in the display part, whatever objects that is we tried to draw, we are calling here, and you are setting those. So here using our GL, you look at your positioning your camera for the viewing purpose. Then using the light function, you're adding the light source, meaning to say that within your program you're trying to add a light source. So that is the meaning of this. And here you're calling the teapot function, tabletop, table leg. And here since we need four table legs, we have called it four times. And then wall here. And so what are we doing here is you're creating one wall, and then you're performing a rotation, and then the second wall, and in the same way rotating, and then you're creating the third wall. So in this way, all our objects have been displayed using our display callback function. And then in the init, nothing much is happening. We are just setting our matrix mode to the projection view, and then loading your identity matrix, and then your setting all your far, near, all these values within your projectional GL ortho. And once you're done with this projection, again you're setting your mode to the model view. Every time we do this, we just perform any kind of projection or whatever activity, again you'll always have to set to the model view. Once you have made changes in your matrix, again it is to make sure that you are back to the model view. So in the main function, here what are we doing again? specified your buffer as single, the color mode is RGB, and you have enabled your depth buffer, because we need to again verify your you are going to compare your depth buffer. And then your window size, you have set the window position, some name for your graphics window as teapot on a table, and then my init we are calling. So my init, I told you what functionality it is doing, and your display function, it is basically the rendered objects are being called. And all the other different properties we are enabling, first is the lighting properties we are enabling here, and then the light source we are enabling, and we are choosing the smooth shading here using GL underscore smooth. So what is this is, either you can go for the shade mode, you can go for the flat shading or the smooth shading. So in smooth shading, what happens is, so the shading or the color changes happen from pixel to pixel, so that gives you a smooth shading effect. So that's the name, that's the reason the name smooth shading is given. But when you are opting for a flat shading, it is not in a you know, such a continuous way, in a discontinuous way your color changes. So that transition is not very smooth in a flat shading. So you can either choose between any of them. So here we opt for the smooth shading. And then in normalize, we are enabling our normal vectors to the unit length. And then again, GL underscore depth test is enabled to again compare or for the depth comparison. And here, as and when we are calling respective functions, whatever I explained in the previous functions, they are being called. So here our main intention is to render these objects and enable the light source. And actually this program, in some, actually you'll have to get a shade here, but in some systems you we get this shadow, and in some systems you're not getting the shadow. So don't worry about it as of now. Just understand the logic and what are the different functions which are available here. Thank you, everyone.